Hi, welcome to Susie Snacks, where I give you bite-sized information, strategies, and tools to grow your business, which is the cocktail for success. And today, I'm going to talk about how to tap into your passion. So how do you tap into your purpose? Do you feel like a fish out of water? And yet, like the fish, if you feel like you're dying inside, listen up. It could be we just need to push you into another direction, into a more satisfying ocean. See, I want you to listen to your dissatisfaction. We've been taught to believe that dissatisfaction is a bad thing and that we should do everything possible to avoid it. Shove it away, ignore it, act like it doesn't bother us, take a pill, plaster on a smile, buy something new, or decide that misery is the best part of the bearing our cross. But above all, don't consider that God might be using us, using it to make us uncomfortable so that we'll want to swim in another ocean where our gifts can shine. Don't get me wrong, dissatisfaction can be a result of an indication that we're not on our purpose, but can also be a road sign that has us looking for our purpose. So if you're miserable in your current career, your current job, and you've been miserable for a long time, you've prayed, you sought counsel from others, you looked for guidance through everything and you're still miserable, consider there may be another plan. Listen to others. One of my closest girlfriends lights up when she talks about mentoring young women. She also has a tremendous business sense. Perhaps her plan may be to start a mentoring organization. When I shared my thoughts with her, you know what? She said, I've heard that from a ton of people. Just as dissatisfaction can be a roadmap to finding your purpose, listen to what others say your gifts are. So when somebody notices or comments on your talents or your gifts, take notes. The universe is trying to tell you something through other people's experiences. There are times, however, where we shouldn't listen to what other people say. But when what they say about us agrees with our passion, internal conviction, our gift is revealed to us. It can be a solid indication that that is your God-given purpose. Listen to your gifts. Have you ever considered what your talents and gifts are? Do you love business? Do you love people? Are you a health and fitness buff? Are you a strategic thinker, a great listener? Can you motivate others into action with your words? Are you skilled at building things? I suggest making a list of all the activities of interest in which you excel in. You can also ask yourself, what's the one thing I do better than anybody else? This can also be a great clue to what is your purpose. The gifts that are given to us are like little seeds planted inside of us. But for them to grow, we have to use them. This means that if you can't identify which gift seeds you have, try doing new things that interest you. Though these are new experiences, you'll learn more about who you are and what's your plan and how that plan will unfold. You just can't sit back and wait for it to be in action. Listen to your passions. If I could ask what makes you angry, joyful, excited, or passionate, what would you say? Take note when those emotions are moved. Sometimes these are just the sign of our purpose. I get fired up about the condition of the world. When I hear about children being abused, I get angry. When someone tells me a story about loyal love, I get deeply moved. An exquisite arrangement of words on a page fill my heart with passion. A story of someone's heartbreak gives me grief. Talking about business stirs my soul. It lights me up. Coupled with my talents, these passion points are my direction for my purpose, of what's the written and unspoken communication about how things deeply impact people and my spiritual and emotional level. Ask to be shown what's the gifts that you have and make a list. And remember, each of us are here for a purpose, a bigger purpose, right? My gift from God is my life. My gift back to God is what I do with my life. Lastly, I want you to consider that your purpose is not just yours. It's about what your higher power wants you to do. Therefore, if you ignore it or neglect your dissatisfaction or what other people say your gifts are and your passions, you're only betraying yourself. You're only betraying your purpose because you've been called for a purpose and it's not ours to keep. It's for others and for you to spread your joy to other people. Your homework, your coursework, your play work, whatever you want to call it, is tap into those things that bring you joy. Tap into those things that aren't hard work for you. Business shouldn't be hard, right? I love what I do. I wake up and I get lost inside my work. All of a sudden it's, you know, late afternoon, it's early evening. I can go into late night and not realize how long I've worked because I'm in my zone. I want you to find your zone. If you're not in your zone now, keep searching, keep digging. I promise you, it's worth it. It's worth the work and it's worth the wait. I'm your sister in prosperity and I can't wait to hear what your purpose is.